Henkel Innovation Challenge is not the usual invite-only B-School competition that we are generally exposed to. It's a competition where anybody, right from an engineering student to a B-School student, can take part in. And that is exactly why we weren't really weighing our chances of actually going on to make a mark in the final stages of the competition. And yet we did, and it felt extremely amazing. And this feeling of ecstasy has not died, really. I still feel like, you know, we're just still ecstatic about it.
Well, it feels awesome. It feels great to be the national announcer for Henkel Innovation Challenge 8, to present in front of so many industry stalwarts. And actually, there were so many other B-School participants, and we began the national announcer. So it was awesome. So our idea for the Henkel Innovation Challenge was in the laundry space, since Henkel is already a major player in the laundry segment, and we tried to identify the gap in the market. So we have washing powders in the market, and we identified that there are no products in the drying space.
Therefore, we really understood that, you know, if you can come up with any sort of an innovative product that quickly dries clothes, it would be something that's really attractive to the consumer. Because right now there's only the dryer, and a dryer takes time to dry your clothes. So you came up with a product with the help of a biodegradable product on which we did a lot of research on. Using this particular biodegradable product and a machine that we created, a prototype of which we created, we showed that you can instantly and automatically get your clothes dried instantly. That was the main innovation that we have. So the first thing that we really did was that the presentation that we have, the .ppt file, we ensured that each slide was minimalist. Very few words on each slide, so that no one gets bored, it doesn't feel monotonous. And to add some flavor to it, we added cartoon images, funny quips, and catchy images also in the same place. So it was colorful and very catchy at the same time.
And to start with the presentation, we did a role play over there to actually demonstrate the idea of our product and to also to catch the attention of the judges over there.
So the role play was a very 70s, 80s sort of a thing, where the mom, finds that her son has been, that her son has blood marks all over the shirt, and is slowly dying and saying "Ma, and dying slowly, and the mom comes in slow motion and holds the son, and then eventually, you know, Insta-dry comes in handy. It's sprayed over the shirt, and all the pockets of, you know, like dirt and blood get washed away instantly. That was the thing that we started off the presentation with. And then also, to add some more flavor to it and add some more wackiness or weirdness to it, if I might call it that, we added some musical elements to it. We played the ukulele while he was on percussion. He added little sound effects. Yes. And so, you know.
Yeah, so I was actually supporting Samantak. He was playing the ukulele, and we actually made a jingle for
a few jingles
yeah, to support our presentation. And lastly, we kept a slide for the love of Vienna.
It was called For the Love of Vienna, because the final prize was to go to Vienna. That was the thing. Just to end off things, this is little experience that we had, you might call it that. Unfortunately, the president of Henkel India was not there in the panel when we were presenting. He'd gone out for some reason or the other. So, eventually, after all the teams had presented and the whole process was over, the president got on the stage and was handing out the participation certificates to each team. When our turn came to actually go up the stage and take it from him, and receive it rather, he suddenly tells us, "Were you the guys who played the guitar?" And we said, "Yes, sir." And then we walk off. And then it strikes us, how did he come to know? He was not in the panel. And then we start feeling, there's more to it than meets the eye.